Good morning. Got my lab coat on and I'm ready to tie a few flies. Today this is going to be a three-wing caddis. I'm using high float fibers. I'm going to use tan. I'm using a tan thread, size 14 dry fly hook. I'm going to use some crab dubbing that I made into a dry fly with some dry fly dubbing added to it and a bunch of legs. It's a very simple pattern. You can use it as a caddis or as a stonefly. Because you can just shape the wings with a pair of scissors. The body of this fly is going to be the thread color, which is I'm going to put tan here. I'm going to layer the body or the shank of the hook. I'm going to take some of my high float fibers. What I want to do is take not a huge amount of it. So I'm going to cut it right back here because I'm going to use quite a bit of it. I'm going to take this piece here, I'm going to trim it flat, and I'm going to trim it at an angle like a caddis wing, okay? I'm going to put this right at the bend, right here, and you make your length of your wing afterward, basically, because you can trim it. Tie it down right here, go up. Cut it off. Save this piece because I'm going to use it for another wing in a minute. Go up here, put another wing, and this is going to go just, let me trim that nice so I can see what I'm doing. I'm going to go right here, just behind the length of the first wing. Tie that down. I'm going to trim this again. Tie it down, and then I'm going to put another wing, the third wing, right over this, just a little bit back of the second wing, like a staggered look. Alright, I'm going to cut this, and I can save this for another fly. Tie this down, wing. Now, I'm going to take my dubbing. You can use any dubbing, dry fly dubbing, but I like the mixture of various colors in here. I like the legs already included in it. So it makes it a nice, so you have the legs like on a normal caddis. Alright, I'm going to dub this. This will help float the fly a little bit better. I'm going to go right up front. You notice it's a little bit past halfway, really, I'm making the thorax of this fly. I want those legs to show. Trim this. Alright. Now, I'm going to take my piece of Velcro. Go on top. Bring it out a little bit. I'm holding the wing down. I want to drag my wing into this. Underneath a little bit. And I'm going to trim this the length of the legs I want. You can actually take it and trim the bottom if you want a flat bottom. A few legs out. Now I'm going to take my wing here. I'm going to trim it down this way. I'm going to take it underneath and trim it up a little bit. Because that's what a caddis wing looks like. Now if I want a little bit more legs out, I'll take my Velcro. There, I got a few more out there. I'm going to trim it. There it is. A really simple pattern. It looks from the top, underneath, and from the side. This is a high float three-wing caddis. A very simple pattern. The high float fibers, it looks like a Goddard caddis because of the shape, but it has a tremendous amount of floatability just because of the high float fibers. This thing should float very, very well in the water. And it has a nice silhouette, as you can see here, with the high float wing. Three sets of wing, crab dubbing, dry fly dubbing in front, brushed up. That's it. The three wing high float cat.
I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly to my surprise,
he did the match.
He did the monster match.
The monster match.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the match.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the match.
He did the monster match. From my laboratory in the castle east to the master bedroom where the vampires feast, the ghouls all came from their humble abode to get a jolt from my electrode.
They did the match.
They did the monster match.
The monster match.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the match.
It caught on in a flash.
They did the match.
They did the monster match. The zombies were having fun. The party had just